गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस हाउ टू डिफरेंशिएट दी मेगलोब्लास्टिक अनीमिया एंड हीमोलिटिक अनीमिया यूजिंग हिस्टोग्राम्स। माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर एस के सूत्रकार, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पैथोलॉजी। सो दिस इज़ अ टिपिकल चैलेंज फॉर पैथोलॉजिस्ट टू डिफरेंशिएट दीज टू कंडीशंस विदाउट सीइंग दी स्मेयर्स। सो हेयर वी विल डिस्कस हाउ वी कैन ईजीली बेसिकली डिस्टिंग्विश और डिफरेंशिएट दीज टू कंडीशन विद द हेल्प ऑफ हिस्टोग्राम्स। So before going to the cases, we should know about the RBC histograms and the WBC histograms, which are basically important in order to differentiate these two conditions. The RBC histograms, it is a basically homogeneous curve, and it appears as a bell shaped, and the peak of this curve is basically used to calculate the MCV and the RDW. And most of the area it represent between 60 femtoliter to 125 femtoliters. So this is a typical type of RBC histogram. In the RBC histogram, there are basically two discriminator which discriminate these curve from the other curve. So the first discriminator, it is called as RL discriminator or RL lower discriminator. On the second other hand, there is a second discriminator, it is called as RU, and it is also called as upper discriminator. So this RL basically it fluctuates between 25 to 75 femtoliters. On the other hand, the RU basically it fluctuates between the 200 and 250 femtoliters. So if we go through the WBC histogram, so this is a typical plotting of the WBC histogram. Here we can see the three cell population. And these fractions F1, F2 and F3. The F1 fraction is basically the small lymphocytes. The F2 fraction is basically composed of eosinophils, basophils and monocytes. And the F3 fraction, it is consist of neutrophils. So the ending of this curve is very important. The curve, WBC curve, basically it ends between the 200 to 250 femtoliters. So this is very important that the ending of this curve we should know. So in order to differentiate these two conditions, megaloblastic anemia and the hemolytic anemia, the observation of these two histograms is done, basically the RBC histogram and the WBC histogram. So these are very important, and in both the conditions, the RBC histograms, they are basically appear very similar, and there is a basically right shift of the curve with the high RDW and high MCV. So this RBC histograms, basically it is very similar in both the condition, but there is a difference in the WBC histogram. In case of megaloblastic anemia, usually this WBC histogram, it is extended up to 300 femtoliters, and in case of hemolytic anemia, this WBC histogram, basically it ends up to 250 femtoliters. So this is a very important differentiating feature between the two conditions. So we will discuss about the different type of cases. I have included four cases in this presentation. So we will discuss how we will basically distinguish these two conditions. So this is the case number one. On the left side, there is a normal histogram and with normal counts. Here you can see typical plotting of the histograms. On the other right side, this is the histogram of a patient, and here you can see the WBC histogram, RBC histogram and the platelet histogram. So if we analyze the counts of this patient, basically the MCV, it is very high, it is around 132.5 femtoliters, and same time the RDW, it is around 23.5 femtoliters. So that means there is very large size RBC, they are present, and there is a high degree of variation as well is there in this blood sample. On the other hand, if we observe the WBC histogram, we will see that this histogram is basically extending up to 300 femtoliters, and when it extend up to 300 femtoliters, that means there are presence of hypersegmented neutrophils. So we can, by just knowing these two histograms, we can clearly diagnose it as a case of megaloblastic anemia. So for to confirm this condition, if we see the peripheral vision of this patient, before going to this, we will see the changes in the histograms. As I said, the WBC curve is normal and it is extending up to the 300 femtoliters. And on the other hand, RBC curve, it is totally shifted towards the right, and there is a high degree of variation between the cells, and so there is a high RWCV, and the platelet histogram shows low platelet counts. If we see the peripheral vision of this particular patient, we will see that there is a presence of macroovulocyte along with the presence of hypersegmented neutrophils, which are seen in the encircled area. And apart from this, there is a presence of microcyte as well as cystocytes. So this is a typical finding which is seen in the megaloblastic anemia, presence of hypersegmented neutrophils. And these can be assessed on the histogram as well. So this is very important, and we can easily diagnose this condition by just knowing the changes in the histograms. So this is the second case. Basically, in this case, here you can see the plotting of the curve. On the right side, the curve is of patient. Here you can see in the RBC histogram, it is widened, and the MCB of this particular patient is 112.5 femtoliters, and the RDW is around 29.1%. But if we analyze the WBC histograms, we can see the curve is ending around 200 femtoliters. So this is a very important finding. When the curve end around 200 or 250 femtoliters, then we can say this is a typical case of hemolytic anemia. So by just knowing these two curves and the ending of the WBC histogram, we can easily able to diagnose the condition. So these are the changes which basically we observe on the histogram, that is the WBC curve is normal and it is ending up to 200 femtoliters. On the other hand, the RBC histogram, it is totally shifted towards the right, and most of the cell they are macrocytic, and there is high degree of variation between these cells, and because of that there is high RDWCV. And the patient is the platelet count are low. If we go through the peripheral of this particular patient, we can see the presence of cystocytes and round macrocytes. And apart from that, we can also see the presence of nucleated RBCs and the spherocytes. So these are the findings basically commonly seen in case of hemolytic anemia. But before seeing these SMAs, we can easily diagnose these condition by just knowing the histograms. So this is the third case. Here you can see the curve, WBC curve, it is extending up to 300 femtoliters, and the RBC curve, it is totally shift, and there is a right shift of the RBC histogram or RBC curve with a high MCB and a high RDW. If we analyze the peripheral vision of this patient, there is a presence of hypersegmented neutrophils, and there is macroovulocytes. So here you can easily appreciate that this is a case of typical case of megaloblastic anemia, but just by knowing the changes in these two histograms. This is another case. Here you can see the WBC histogram, it is ending just before the 200 femtoliters. That means there is no hypersegmentation. And on the other hand, the RBC histogram shows there is a right shift of the curve, and the MCB, it is very high, it is around 148.4 femtoliters, and the RDW, it is around 24.0%. On the other hand, we observe the peripheral smear of this patient, we will see round macrocyte along with the plenty of nucleated RBC. So these are the few cases by which we can easily appreciate the changes in the histograms in order to differentiate these two conditions, megaloblastic anemia and hemolytic anemia. I hope this video will be useful for you. Thank you very much for watching this.